y'all. So I'm finally recording this video after almost 5 months now. So I know a lot of you have been wondering what has happened, where I've been, and have been asking for an update and all that. So here it is. So in January, late January of this year, I wrecked my car, which is why my eye looks like this. So if I look crazy, if I look ashy, whatever, I apologize because I still cannot see, okay? So let me get a little closer. A lot of people have been asking how my eye looks now. This is how it looks now. This is the eye I still can't see out of. Okay, so I'm still a little ashamed of it. That's why nobody has seen me. I haven't taken any pictures to post on social media, nothing, because of how I look now. So like I said, I cannot see out of my eye at all. And the reason behind that is because the airbag hit me in the face upon impact when I wrecked my car. So what happened was I blacked out. A lot of people don't know, but I tend to cough a lot. No, I don't have COVID or anything like that. It's no kind of infection, nothing. But ever since I was intubated or on life support in 2015, I've had trouble with coughing. Like a lot of things are triggers for my cough. Eating, smells, both good and bad, getting too hot, too cold, anything makes me cough, literally. And sometimes it's a productive cough, so I like cough up a little bit of mucus. So eating is very difficult for me. Like eating is literally a burden. But this particular day after class, I had a test that day, I decided I was going to come back home. Then I said, no, I'm gonna go to the grocery store and get something to eat. So me walking through the grocery store kind of made my body irritated, and I still had a lot of fluid on too. So I could like feel the fluid moving, which also is an irritant and makes me cough. So I started coughing when I went to get something to eat. And while I was in line at the drive-thru, I was coughing. I always keep a cup or something in the car so I can like have something to spit in and some tissue. So I remember coughing, and it was like a big glob of mucus, like more than I had ever coughed up before. So I was like, that's really unusual. Like it was literally like that much in the bottom of the cup. And I was like, that's kind of scary. And so I'm just coughing, and they trying to hand me my food, and I'm coughing. I was like, these people are gonna think I have COVID. Like, they're gonna be like, then we don't want to take her money, you know? So I was like, so it's really embarrassing being in public when this happens, which is also why I do not like to go out to eat, because people are rude and they like to stare. And they also assume, of course, that I have COVID. So it's that's why I don't know. I just don't know. So like I said, I was in the drive-thru, I was coughing. And then as I got my food and I was pulling off to, you know, turn back into the road to go home, I said, I'm a little lightheaded. I was still coughing. And I feel like I'm about to pass out. I was having trouble breathing. I get on down the road. I was like, I'm going to have to pull over. So I was like, where can I pull over at? Well, I'm in the middle of the city. There's nowhere to pull over at. So I'm driving, and I get past the Walmart. And I was getting closer and closer to my apartment where I used to stay. I'm in my new apartment now. But anyway, I'm blabbing. I'm getting all off subject. My goodness. So I was like, I gotta find somewhere to pull over at. And I actually ended up pulling over on the road where I live now. So every time I leave home, I see where I wrecked my car in January. So I started coughing again. I was like, let me cut my flashers on. I'm just gonna pull over in the middle of the road. So I went to turn to the right to pull over at this road, because there's only one lane when you turn to the right, but like coming out is three, like a turning lane to the left and two turning lanes to the left and a turning lane to the right. But when you're coming down the road, it's just one lane. So I put my flashers on, so I'm just about to sit here, and it's a median, so, and a sidewalk, so it was nowhere for me to actually pull off of the road. So I remember getting to the light, I turned my flashers on, I coughed one more time, I remember turning the wheel, and that was it. I blacked out right when I was turning. And I ended up running up a fence and hitting a tree. So my car was literally sitting in the air like this. And I hit a tree. My car was totaled, of course, because the airbags came out. And like I said, airbag hit me in the face. When I woke up, I was like this in the car. Over the middle console in between the seat like this. And it was a guy in my front seat. And he was like, ma'am, are you okay? Are you okay? And I'm like, how did you even get in here? So I'm trying to come to and talk. And I was like, and I remember seeing him. And as he's on the phone with 911, he was like, she's coming too. She's coming too. And the lady was like, is she conscious? Like she just sounded like she didn't care about what was going on the whole time. And I was like, I remember saying, ow, my face. Like this whole side of my face was numb. And my eye was hurting so bad. As I'm sitting there, the car was still running, everything. But I'm still trying to figure out how this man got in my car. He was a young dude, like my age, maybe younger. And I'm just like, what the world? And I remember looking out my window, seeing the police. And he's trying to open my door. And it was a young black girl. And EMT and the ambulance was in the middle of the median there and all that. And this guy was like, he said, she's trying to talk still. She's trying to talk. He was like, are you okay? And I was like, I'm a type 1 diabetic, hypertension, I'm on dialysis. So I was trying to give him like my problem list of what was going on with me so he could let 911 know. But like I said, the ambulance is already there. I didn't know that. So then I asked him how to get in my car. He never did answer. So I don't know if when I was trying to pull over, because I was trying to roll the window down because I got hot, I must have hit the unlock button before I hit the tree, and that's how he was able to get in the car, because all my windows were up. That's the only thing I could think. That's the only way I could think that he got in the car, because none of my windows were broken. Like I said, none of them were down. So, yeah, I don't know. So, and the longer I sat there, my vision started to go down, and my face started to hurt more and more. But I was breathing better when I woke up, which was weird to me. Then I remember this really tall police officer and this really tall EMT walking me to the ambulance. And once they finally got my door open, because like I said, I had ran over a fence. So my door was stuck on that chain link fence. So they were trying to pull it open. So I had to step on the fence, you know, to get out and walk to the ambulance there. So I remember walking to the ambulance. As I'm walking, I remember it seemed like my vision was literally going down, just like this, literally. Like I couldn't see, like the swelling was getting worse, but I didn't know my face was swollen until the EMT told me on the ambulance. He was like, can you see anything at all? And I told him, I said, yeah, I can see a little bit. I said, but I feel like it's getting worse. I can only see you from your chest down. I said, I can see everything from your chest down in the ambulance. If I look up, I can't see anything. He was like, okay. But he never told me just how bad it was. He never said it, I guess because he didn't want to scare me. But I told him that I thought I had a concussion because my head was hurting so bad. And I told him that I think I hit my head somewhere on the steering wheel or something. And I remember calling my mom. So I was on FaceTime, my mom, I was crying. Like, I'm sorry. Because at the time, she was paying for my car payment. Before that, I had been making all my car payments. But at that particular time, she was making the payments. Because I was using my money from school to pay on my car. Since I don't get financial aid anymore, I couldn't pay on my car anymore. So it was like, it's either find some other way to pay for the car or let them take it. So my mom ended up paying for it for me. So me really not getting financial aid anymore kind of hurt me in that one way when it came to paying for my car. But everything else, I didn't have problems affording anything else. It was just my car. My car was the only bill I could not afford. Anyway, so, well, now I don't have it because I folded it up. But, so that's what happened with that. Update on my eye. Like I said, I still can't see nothing out of it at all. I can see a little light, like if I look up, I can see light, but like I can see my ring light, but that's really it. I just see shadows basically. So if I do like this, it's literally black, and then it's like some kind of light here at the bottom like this. But I can't see my hand moving or anything like that. I can't see anything. So that's why I have not gotten another car, because I can't see well enough to drive. This eye is still very blurry. My blood pressure has been up because I've just been laying around, and there's a lot of swelling in the retina in the back of my eye, which was a pre-existing condition. And when I went to my eye doctor, I went in February. My accident was January 25th. I was in the ER for 13 hours until I was actually seen by the physician assistant in the emergency room. Complete waste of time. I know they say you should go get checked out after an accident or whatever, but I knew it was going to be a waste of time. I know how things go in the emergency room. Waste of time, just like I said. They gave me a Vicodin while I was there, and then sent me home and gave me a prescription for some muscle relaxers, and those worked for all of maybe 3 days. Yeah, so I was in here pretty much crying every day because I was in so much pain. My face was swollen shut. I couldn't see to do anything. My mom came and stayed with me for a couple of days until I was able to see a little bit better out of my right eye. I do not feel as though my vision is going to improve. I'm just being honest. I don't see it happening. I know people should always say, think positive, but sometimes in certain situations, thinking positive is childish. And I'm just being honest. That's childish because, especially considering my situation, it's not going to get better without surgery, pretty much. Because I still have a lot of blood in my eye, which is why I can't see out of it. So the eye doctor cannot see into it. Also, I'm going to apologize. Might be a lot of jump cuts in this video because I'm waiting for my food to be delivered. Because I can't cook anything, because I can't see to cook anything. I still cannot pretty much see my phone. I've been using this magnifying glass as well as the magnifier on my phone and two pairs of reading glasses just to see anything on my phone. So again, I apologize if you send me anything and I don't reply. I get frustrated. I get tired of reading it. I'm just being honest. I get tired of trying to read it. I don't care that much. I'm sorry. I don't. But I love you all and I appreciate you all for sending me things. If you're tagged in this video when I post it on Facebook, you help me in some kind of way, whether it's been monetary, being there as a friend, just to listen, making suggestions, giving me rides when I need a ride to go somewhere. I appreciate you all so very much. I'm trying to think of what else I need to tell you all in regards to all of this. I was able to start riding with a medical transportation system, I guess you could say, here in Greensboro, which is covered by my insurance. So I don't have to take Ubers and Lyft anymore, thank God. But occasionally I do because I have to call in once a week to schedule the ride, and I have to do it 2 days in advance. And as you all know, I go to Dallas Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So if I don't call that Saturday, then I don't have a ride that Monday. So most of the time I have to still take an Uber or Lyft home, well, to and from Dallas on Monday. But other than that, things are doing fine. I've been getting my groceries delivered, which is still money because they charge a delivery fee. I'm sorry, my voice is cracking. I've been having really bad night sweats and I've been sleeping with the fan on. So I've lost my voice recently within the last 2 days. But yeah, sorry about that. If you all can tell, I don't know if you all can tell, but I can tell. But I think that's all I had to tell you all. Also, these are my eye drops. I'm taking 4 different ones. Well, 3. One of them I take because this is just a regular, natural tear because it helps them not burn, because these other 3 burn really bad. These are my prescription eye drops, these 3. I have to take them. This one 2 times a day, and these 2 4 times a day. So all 3 go in the right eye, and then my left eye is just this one. But like I said, they burn really bad. So if I don't drop this one in first and then do these, it will burn. And I can't take it. I can't take it. Like, it's a lot. I've been dealing with a lot. I had to withdraw from school. I recently saw a lung doctor and put me on 2 more pills. So now I'm taking 8 pills a day. So, yeah, it's been a lot. Plus my 2 insulin shots that I've been taking for years now. But most of those pills are my kidney pills. But the 2 pills that I'm on now is from the lung doctor I saw. And he said he thinks my coughing is pretty much my body saying that it's something in my throat when it's really not. But I think I have gastroparesis, which is a stomach condition where the food in my stomach does not digest within an hour like most people's stomach does. Mine takes about 5 to 6 hours. Sometimes it takes about 12. But I literally be coughing, like, as soon as I swallow, I cough, vomit it back up every single time. But he said he thinks that it's actually, I have nerve damage in my throat from being intubated. I think I said that already, but I saw him last week and he gave me 2 pills to kind of help with the nerves in my throat. He said what happens is when you're intubated, when they put the tube in, the nerves at the top and back of your throat are literally ripped away when they put the tube in. So it damages the voice box as well as the nerves over the voice box. So we'll see how that goes. Also, I'm gonna have to go in for a swallowing test. So we'll see what progress I can make with that. Even if my vision doesn't get better, I just really cannot deal with the coughing because, like I said, eating is a burden. I cannot get through a meal without vomiting. Another thing, I know we might get a little TMI in this video, but another thing, the reason why I be so sad is because I never thought that at my age, I would have trouble controlling my bowels or my urine. So, and being that my kidneys are both dead, I should not be peeing on myself when I cough. Makes absolutely no sense. I will cough and pee on myself every day. Never fails. I either cough and pee on myself, or cough and vomit on myself, or cough and I have to spit up mucus every day. Never fails. Never thought at this age I would be dealing with something like that. And then the whole with my bowels, me controlling my bowels, is because of all the medications I take. They upset my stomach. If I don't take them at the right time when I'm eating, my stomach will be upset all day. Literally. Hold on, you guys. I think my food is here. And it is. Okay, but I'm gonna eat that when I finish. Because I didn't want to eat before I started because I didn't want to start coughing and vomiting on camera, like I just said. So yeah, it literally takes me about an hour and a half to get through about one meal just to get it down and get it to stay down. And it's a wonder that I'm not dead already because I can't keep any food down. It's just like, what nutrition am I really getting? Right. And then also another fun fact, I didn't want to share this with a lot of people, but I feel like it's important for me to say, my accident happened because I asked for it. I literally did. I was so sad and tired of coughing and vomiting every day, just walking around, laying down, sitting down, just doing nothing made me cough, and it was irritating. And the one thing that I enjoyed the most, I can't enjoy it no more, and that was eating. So I was really upset, and I was just like, once again, I prayed for death. I prayed for death when I had my stroke, woke up in the hospital. Again, God said, I'm just kidding. I'm just going to bang you up really bad and send you back on your way. Again, that's what happened again this time. I was praying for death. I don't want to be here no more. I don't have the courage to actually kill myself, but I was praying for it, hoping that something would happen and I would die, you know? And again, like I said, I was praying for it, wrecked my car. Once again, God didn't give me what I asked for, never does, obviously. Just bang me up really bad and send me back on my way. Just make things a little worse. Just a little worse for me to deal with. And I'm just like, my mom was like, so maybe God was just giving you more time to think about it. And I was like, think about what? I already knew what I wanted. I wanted to die. There was nothing to think about. So here I am, struggling more than before. Yay, as to be expected when it comes to my life. It's to be expected. It really is. So, yeah, that's how things have been going. That is the update on my life. Yeah, I think I've covered everything. Nothing else has really happened. I'm currently trying to get back into school, but I don't know if that's really a good idea. I don't think I really want to do it anymore. One, because it's taking me so long, and then I keep getting sick and things keep happening, and then this time I had to withdraw again. So that's been a process of me trying to get back into school. I recently just submitted my application to reapply last week. I had to redo it. I did it a month or two ago, but I had to redo it because I messed up. So that was two application fees I had to pay for, more money that I didn't need to be throwing out there. I know you're like, but Deanna, you just ordered food, that's money. Listen, gotta eat somehow. But I still, you know, get my groceries, so I don't have to worry about that as far as, like, money for food. So that's not a problem. But the only thing I was really having trouble with was paying for my Ubers and Lyfts. So like I said, I do appreciate you all for your donations as far as that. But please don't forget about me. I still do need help. Okay, so my phone stopped recording, but I'm gonna make this quick. I stopped to eat and I started sweating, so like I said, I'm gonna make this quick. Again, thank you all so very much. As I was saying previously, I do still need you all's help, so please don't forget about me. I'm trying to find other avenues to pay for school, as well as other things as far as dealing with other necessities and things like that. I did recently buy some glasses, which is a waste of money because I can't see out of them because my vision literally varies by the day. Excuse me. But thank you all so much. Like I said, I'll try to keep you all updated, and I will insert some pictures either throughout this video or at the end of this video of my progress of how my eyes started to look better as time went on. I took a picture every week for the first 4 weeks, and after that it was every other week. So yeah, I will try to insert those pictures in this video somewhere. But thank you all so much for watching. Again, I'm rambling, so it's time for me to go. Bye. Love you all so very much, and I hope you all stay tuned for the journey.
Okay, so this first picture here is actually of me in the hospital just after my accident. And then this next picture here is about 3 or 4 days later when I was moving out of my old apartment. And this was me the following week in my new apartment, and the swelling had gone down. Still didn't have too much improvement in my vision. And then right here was 2 weeks after the accident. Still couldn't see too great out of either eye, of course. This was actually me right here at my eye appointment at Duke. And eye doctor didn't seem to really care about what was going on. And then right here was the 4th week, so about a month after the accident. All the swelling had pretty much gone down. And this was just me in treatment last week. My eye was a little bit irritated, so it was a little bit swollen and red. But anyway, I want to thank you all so very much for watching this video. Again, please do not forget about me. I will have my link in the description, and if you stay tuned to the end, I appreciate you so very much, because It took a lot for me to make this video because I really cannot see. I cannot stress that enough. Like, this was very difficult for me. But again, thank you so very much. I love you all, and I'll try to upload again soon.